Hey everyone, PadreBolt22 here. Thanks for coming by. This is week 6 of Kitty Claw Friday. The recordings of these streams will be exclusively here on my YouTube channel, but if you want to see them live, be sure to check me out on Twitch. I'll explain the rules here at the beginning. Now please, enjoy the video. It's time for Kitty Claw Friday week 6. This is an exciting week. This is going to be a new record for the most time added. Hey, how's it going, Stream Elements? Good to see ya. This is a fun little thing I'm gonna do every Friday, where I'm gonna play a near impossible mini game in GTA 6, and, for half an hour, and I'll add 30 minutes, and I'll add 1 minute for every Twitch follower and YouTube subscriber from that week. So it's a little, added for people that have come by. I appreciate everybody, and I'll give everybody a shout out at the end as well. So here we go. We're right here. We're heading in, and I'll switch on the rules once I get inside. Okay, we are inside. Here is the machine. How about that? And now let's put Kitty Claw Friday. There we go. And I can even put in the rules right here. So they're sitting on the screen, should anyone come in and want to see. All right, so here we go. We're going to play Shiny Wasabi Kitty Claw, 30 minutes. And 35 minutes this week, because we have 4 subscribers on Twitch this week and 1 new YouTube subscriber. So basically this is a claw game. A claw here. Let me get out of the way of my fancy painting right there. This is a claw game that is nearly impossible. There is no skill involved whatsoever. It is purely luck. Once you have Once you have touched the toy, it's just a chance at that point whether you get it or not, as long as it shakes as you put your claw down. So I have heard differing reports that the ones in the front are either 1 in 50 or 1 in 100, and the ones in the back go all the way from 1 in 500 to 1 in 1,000. So these are very hard. So through 5 weeks, we have actually got the first 3 plushies. We have the pink guy, the green guy, and the yellow guy. Very funny, after going through the whole spiel of how difficult this was, on the very second of the week, very second of the first week, I got the pink one. So that was funny. And last week we got the yellow guy right there. And we're moving on to the brown dudes, and they are separate characters, so we will be going for both of them, just as a heads up. But let's see if we get it this week. Basically, this is a 30-minute session for me to hang out here. If anybody wants to come in and talk, it's a great time to hang out with people from chat. I have not opened chat on my phone, which I should have done, so let's do that. And here I am continuing. Put that down, and let's bring this up so I can see the chat right in front of me as well. There we go. And this is a exciting, good week. We got lots of people coming in, lots of followers, lots of good conversations with people that came in. Very, very, very happy with the way this has turned out. A lot of people that have come in, and I enjoy everyone that's come in has been super nice. Shout out to anyone that's been here to any of my streams. I would never complain about you, but also, this is just been so nice. Everyone's so nice. Big shout out to the internet. It's a nice place, I guess. It gets a bad rap. And basically, if nobody comes in, this is just the 30-minute Padre Bold podcast. And that's the way the last couple weeks have been, and that's fine, honestly. It's been I've had a lot of stuff to talk about the last couple weeks. I think it's been great content. It's over on YouTube, but not going to do this to plug right here. But I talk about movies. I talk about things that I've run into in my daily life, and I talk about stuff that's happened in-game and on Twitch. Obviously, the biggest news out of this week is the Twitch hack. So if you are watching this and you haven't changed your Twitch passwords, I would mega suggest you do that. It seems like they're out there. I am lucky that I use a password on Twitch I don't use anywhere else, so I don't really need to worry about that too much myself. But if for some reason you were possessed to use like your Twitch same password on Twitch and like your banking, I would never do that. Don't do that. That's a bad idea. Keep your stuff with money in it, separate passwords from your social media and all that. But if you do that, change both of them to separate things, because yeah, that's dangerous. Not good. Not nice. Other things this week gone on Twitch. I lost my first follower, which was a bummer, but they did just delete their account, I think probably because of the Twitch hack, so you know, it's not that bad really. Sorry, I'm looking to see how the white balance is on the side on my face, and I'm looking over to the side. You know, I don't have a $10,000 setup like you know, some crazy people that are doing crazy well. Shout out to them. So I'm making do with what I can. But yeah, I think it looks good. I think it looks better since I have this beautiful painting here covering up the window behind me, or at least half of it. That definitely helps the balance a little bit, that I don't have this light shooting directly at the camera, at least half of it. Is that sitting up straight? It is. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. But, so this week, movie-wise, I saw Carnage, or Venom, Let There Be Carnage, which last week I told you guys that I was expecting a $55 million opening, and it was in the 70s, matching the first Venom, which, that was a surprise to me. Oops. That was a surprise to me. I didn't expect, in these times, where people are being a little extra cautious, I didn't expect an opening weekend to be as that high for a rated R movie, and B, a non-Marvel superhero adjacent movie. But this week we have James Bond, No Time to Die, coming out this weekend, I should say. And boy, I think that's going to do really good. I am willing to go so far as to say this is going to be the first post-COVID 100 million opening. Black Widow just missed that. And I think with the two Marvel movies have come out, Venom's done well, I think people are getting more used to going to the movies. And I think it's time for a blockbuster to really go off. Which is incredible news, because MGM has had a pretty bad run. MGM, the company that owns James Bond at the moment, it has really had a bad run. And with the way that things have been going, I was a little bit worried about their future. And you don't want to see any part of Hollywood going away, because it just means less movies, most likely. It's not like that the slots for movies go somewhere else. They probably just disappear. But that's big news. I think don't be surprised if you see another James Bond pretty soon. It doesn't look like it'll be Daniel Craig, but you never know. Hollywood's weird, and you can never say never. You never say never in that. I think there's a chance. I also think we might be seeing a new Bond within the next 3 years. I think that might be fair to say. But anyway, I didn't give a specific number, so I'm going to go 110 for James Bond. I think I'm willing to go that far. So not just above 100, I'm going to say 110. I think that'll be doable. I really do. I'm going to sneeze. I really do need to get some sort of mic muting apparatus, because this microphone does not have that. And I'd have to alt-tab out of the game, go into Streamlabs, and mute. And I don't have the time for that when a sneeze is coming. You know, the audio in this is this game is ridiculously low, so I'm going to turn that up. Cross your fingers that I'm going to remember to turn that down for Stardew, which is very loud, actually. I mean, it is supposed to be like background noise, so it's not supposed to be super loud, but I think this is good. It's a good middle ground. What do you guys think about mugs? I think, I know it's a weird question, but it feels like mugs are going out of vogue. It's, I don't see mugs for sale on as many things anymore, other than, like, at Disneyland, which is where that's from. It's, Cars Land Season's Greetings. I hope this is gonna show up, Cars Land, Season Speeding, sorry. Sorry, my bad. My bad. Oh. Somebody who followed yesterday actually sent me an article about Stardew Valley, which is the game that I play 3 to 4 days a week on here. And it's akin to how the map on Stardew Valley is akin to the layout of a place like Disneyland, in the way that it is spiraled a little bit to create the illusion of a larger map or a larger park. I think that's pretty cool. I always liked hearing that kind of stuff about Disneyland. Being someone who's lived so close to Disneyland and has had the opportunity to go so many times through friends that have like free passes who work there, to me having season passes in the past, you get to a point where you can appreciate the little things a little bit differently, like appreciate the minor details or the things that are put in that you wouldn't notice if you're just rushing through the park trying to go to point A to point B. I've had days where I went there. People won't get this who don't do this, and I understand. I don't blame anyone for not understanding this, but I've gone in there. I haven't gone on a single ride, and you would say, that's crazy. Why would you go to Disneyland and not go on a ride? But sometimes just looking around a place that you're used to with a more discerning eye, and people watching and enjoying the vibe is something special that most people don't get the opportunity to do anywhere. Because we're always rushing to be somewhere. We always have something to do. We're always trying to do something specific or get something done. And having a moment, I don't want to call it mindfulness, but you kind of know what I mean when I say that. It's zooming out on the moment you're in. And being able to do that in places is very cool experience that I would recommend trying. Go to somewhere that you go all the time, your favorite place or the place you have to go, whether it's school, it might not be your favorite place, but a movie theater, a campus, a theme park, a sports stadium, etc. And the next time you're there, give yourself a couple minutes where you can either, if it's appropriate to do this in public, you can sit there and close your eyes, just use your different senses to experience where you are. The sounds, the smells, And then what's neat about that is the next time you come there, you recognize those things without having to have your zoom out moment. You can, and you have a more, you're more present and you have more of a view of everything that's going on around you. And it's really neat to be able to do that, because to have a broader situational awareness of where you are and what you're doing. I think that's really cool. Some people would say that's, you know, mamby-pamby, wishy-washy. But so much of life is wearing, you know, blinders on, looking straight ahead, tunnel vision. And it's cool to have a moment and then be able to follow up on that moment with the rest of your time at somewhere and be able to zoom out. Feel your whole surroundings as a whole. I think that's really cool. Recommend doing it. There's something different about it. A lot of people like to say, I mean, this is going on too long about this subject, but a lot of people like to say reality is what you make it. And of course, that's not true to many extents, but there is a real level of what you experience is what you perceive. And if you have your tunnel vision and you're not being fully in the moment, you're not perceiving everything and you're not experiencing the reality around you. Whoa, dude, that's far out. I promise this is not normally the kind of things I talk about, but it's something that is very cool to me, that I enjoy. Other things that have gone on this week, we got our first video game girlfriend and wife in Stardew Valley. I think that is pretty cool. That's pretty exciting. we got married in Stardew Valley. That's a cool thing. I don't know where things go from there, but we'll see. We'll see where things go in that game. We're midway through year two. So as far as I know, I'm probably halfway through the game. I think year three, end of year three, is the last thing I've seen mentioned as something happening. There might be more. I don't know. I'm close to a pretty big... next week, I will finish the community center, which is a big thing to do. And I've heard that that opens up more content. I try not to look up that kind of stuff, like, 'cause I do want to be able to experience it and not just be like, hey guys, look at this thing. That's crazy. Whoa. Like, I already know what's happening. I don't know what's coming in Stardew. I am getting my butt kicked in the desert cave, I'll tell you that. Holy cow. That did not go well, I'll tell you that for sure. YouTube videos came back this week. It's big news. We're trying to give myself a little bit more lead time on that, and the streams don't have to go up. Other than this, this one's always going to go up day of. Hey, my little vibes. Just on Fridays, I play this for a little bit. It's just a little thing that I'm going to do every Friday. It's like hanging out with anybody that comes in, or the Padre Bolt cast if anybody doesn't. And it's a fun little thing I do every Friday. Just for 30 minutes plus a minute for every follow and subscriber on YouTube. It's funny, because this game is pretty much near impossible, and just doing this for half an hour is silly. But it takes little to no effort, so I'm able to just chat with anybody that comes in or talk about my week. Partially it's for my enjoyment, because I do want to beat this claw game. Apparently, so I've been told, the guys in the back are like between 1 in 500 and 1 in 1,000 chances to pick up. Like, it's not even a It's not even a skill thing. Like, as long as your claw is close, it's just a chance, 1 in 500 to 1 in 1,000. So, no way I was ever going to be able to do this just in my free time, sitting here for a long, because this is, I think about now I've probably done 3 hours of this on stream with 30 hours, 30 minutes, 6 weeks. And I've gotten the easy ones in the front. Those I've been told are between 1 in 50 and 1 in 100 chance. But I had a little background. I had done this for maybe 2 hours before I started streaming this, and I had not gotten a single one. So it's it's a huge time sink. Like, you're no normal person should ever beat this game without like using like, what do you call them? Like, a not a bot, but you get what I mean. Something that would play the game for you for hours and hours on end. I've seen people say they've run their bot for like 20 hours and beat it. I don't know if that's good or bad time. But yeah, I think it's funny. I think it's funny, and it's nice little content. I didn't want to do a full, 3 to 4 hour stream on Fridays, so this is a nice little way to show up, do 30 minutes plus whatever the follows are, and just hang out. And I'm having a good time with I honestly am enjoying these. I'm enjoying doing. I think the setup's great. I love doing Stardew Valley, and this is a fun little once a week getaway from that. It's like, yeah, I wouldn't just play a normal GTA on stream like that. That's not interesting or good content, or I don't think I would even enjoy having to, try to make that more interesting. I think this is a nice, silly way to do this. Do like my character model though. Like his sandals. He's all ready for the beach. GTA is funny because I've spent a lot of time in LA over the years, and having a game of GTA where I recognize so much of the environment is pretty funny to me. Like, I've been to New York a few times, but like, I don't intimately know New York in the way that I know Los Angeles and the different parts of it as well. Like, I haven't just been to the tourist parts of LA. I've been all around LA over the years. And it's cool to recognize so much of this. Yeah, it's funny to me how I kind of understand as well what things are next to each other in this game compared to real life. It's been funny to me where it's like these two things are like a 30-second drive apart, and it's like an hour drive apart in real life. It's really cool how they've decided to condense Los Angeles with, but still keeping clear lines of there's different parts of the city. I mean, this is I'm not joking when I say this is one of the greatest games of all time. It's incre not the claw game. Ooh, we got another one. We got Poop Head. All right, sorry for yelling, but that's very exciting. The chances of that are not high, and it's 2 weeks in a row now. Got the poopy plushie. That's cool. I'm super happy. That those ones are not supposed to be easy. It's the chances that are low. Thank you. Yay, 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 indeed. I hope that didn't clear the mic. That is probably the loudest I've ever said anything on stream so far. But yeah, GTA is really cool. I wish there was a couple more things like the stadium, the baseball stadium. I think is a would be a cool addition. Obviously, you can't just do that directly because it's like, I probably assume that's copyrighted in some way. But yeah, the and of course, like the Staples Center where the Lakers play in downtown LA isn't in the game. That's definitely something that would have been cool to see. But that would have thrown off the scale of downtown. Like, downtown is so big in real life, and in the game it's like 8 buildings in the middle of the screen. But yeah, GTA, great game. I've heard a lot of conflicting stuff about what GTA 6 would be, and I don't believe any of it, honestly. But I could buy the idea that it's going to have a changing map akin to, like, Fortnite, because that might just be more profitable for them, and I think that's the draw of that is going to be too hard for them to ignore. Because that is one of the coolest things about Fortnite, is that the map changes often, and it changes the experience of the game. And, like, GTA Online is pretty cool. I've sort of backed away from it in the last few weeks because the challenges aren't as rewarding. But I think GTA 6 Online will be a completely different animal compared to this one. And it would be fun to play a GTA Online from the beginning, because I didn't play GTA Online. Oops, hit the wrong guy. I didn't play GTA Online from the very beginning. I started like a year and a half ago, just because when it was free on Epic Games, because I had a few friends that I was like, hey, do you guys want to pick this up with me and we can like sort of grind this out a little bit? And yeah, it worked out. Free games. God bless the Epic Games Store, by the way, because it's amazing how much free stuff you get every week. There's usually like 2 games a week, and many other free things if you wanted to check those out, but that's pretty cool. And the sales, like the quarterly sales, give you like a $10 coupon. What the heck? You ever get that feeling like there's like an ant on your foot, and you know there isn't, but like once you feel it once, like it was probably like a hair from my dog or something like blowing by, but once you get that feeling once, it does not go away, and it's like got me bugging out a little bit. 9 minutes left, man. This half an hour flies by. That's really, that's the thing that's most surprised me, is how quick time goes when I'm streaming. Because you would think that playing this game that is doing a repetitive motion over and over for half an hour would drag on, but it actually goes really fast, and that's cool to me. I guess I just like doing the PB cast, Padre Bold podcast, and seeing if anybody comes in. Either way, I'm really happy either way, by the way. If somebody wants to come in and chat for this time, I think that would be, that's a lot of fun. I love talking to people. Have been so nice. I already said that this week, but people have been so nice on Twitch. But I'm just doing the Padre Bold podcast. Apparently I have half an hour of stuff to talk about every week, because that's what's been going on. No one cares about this, but I am hitting level 100 of Fortnite this week. I think this will be like, I guess since the Marvel season, that might have been season 4. Have I really only been playing for four or five seasons straight? I did play like 2 years ago for a couple seasons, but I let that go and came back for the Marvel stuff. Nobody wants to see me play Fortnite. I will never stream Fortnite. Ever. That would be such terrible content. I am so bad at that game. God bless. I shouldn't keep saying God bless, but I'm so happy for skill-based matchmaking. Because there's such a skill gap in like people that can build and people that can edit and those that can't. Because I can build a little bit, but I never learned editing, and I'm not fast enough to do that. I missed my window to do that when I was a younger dude. It's still a lot of fun. I have a lot of fun playing it with friends, but not something that would be enjoyable for anyone to watch that's not playing. I guarantee that. Like, I've thought about if, like, 100 level death runs would be funny to do on stream. But again, I just don't think I think doing something that niche or niche, whatever the word is, doing that in a category that is so oversaturated, like Fortnite, it's like doing this in GTA. I think this is at least funny content, but playing GTA, like, there's so many people playing GTA, the chances that anyone finds your stream is nothing. So, like, I'm doing this for fun. This is not for gaining followers or anything, because no one that's not following me is ever going to find this. It's so buried among, like, I'll bet if I go on, I'm not going to go right now, but I'll bet if I go on, there's, like, 300k people watching, probably 200k, really, watching GTA right now, and yeah, me at the very bottom is not gonna pick up anything. But I think it's funny to me. I like doing this. I'm not gonna go in that spiel again. I already said that today. But yeah, I think it's silly. Almost 5 minutes. 5 minutes is the bonus time. So I'll give a shout out to everyone that followed this week, and we'll keep going at it for that full time. 5 minutes is a record, by the way. That's the most I've added for follows and YouTube subscriptions. I added YouTube subscriptions this week. That's a new wrinkle to that. But yeah, I don't think adding extra time is that big a deal. I would love to hang out more time. If people want to subscribe on YouTube and add time to that, I would not complain. Yeah, dear. So there's 5 minutes. So we're into the bonus time already. Time flies. So I do want to give a special shout out to MellowVibes21. Thank you for following and coming by this week. Shout out to B Simps, Valiant Echo, and So Near Age. People who have followed on Twitch this week, and YouTube does not show subscribers individually. So I'm 99% sure who it was. So shout out to you. Yeah, so shout out to 4 followers and 1 YouTube subscriber this week. That's a record. See, wrong guy. Continue to grow, hopefully. Continue to have cool people come in to chat with. Makes me happy to see anyone come by. I'm going to work over the next week to not say as much. I think that is probably annoying, but we'll work on that. I have mostly beaten out of myself talking like this while I'm doing something and filling time. I'm doing my best not to do that anymore, because that's annoying. If I hear someone do that in real life, I mean, I would be pulling my hair out. That would be terrible. But yeah, I think that's a good progress for me. I definitely think I'm getting better. I think I'm getting better at talking for long periods of time, not leaving long periods of silence. That's bad. Nobody wants that. I don't want that. Nobody listening wants to hear that. That's nothing. But yeah, pretty cool. Pretty cool overall. A super successful week, in my opinion. And I don't know. I guess I had 33 minutes of things to talk about. And now I'm depressed on the last couple minutes. I guess, what am I going to do this weekend? I think I'm probably going to try to go see James Bond. I'm going to try to see that in IMAX. We'll see if I can find a weird time to go where not as many people are there. Because I just don't want to be in a gigantic crowd. Charger game on Sunday. Going up to LA to see Chargers play the Browns. That's pretty cool. And other movies I might see here. I'll say, here's 2 more movies that I have on my docket. The Card Counter and the Aretha Franklin documentary, Respect. That's pretty cool. That is certainly terrible. Terrible. I don't want to ever do that again. Do just a silly noise when I've run out of things to talk about. I guess if time keeps getting added, I need to write a couple more topics to talk about on Fridays, which, you know, that probably wouldn't be a bad idea. That wouldn't be a bad idea to do that most days, just to have a little bit extra to talk about. But yeah, hopefully next week is successful as well. I get this other plushie. It's funny, these guys are twins. But yeah, it's cool. Oops, we got the wrong guy. But here, with the last minute, I'm going to go for the main character of the GTA anime, Princess Robot Bubblegum. She's in the back, all the way back there. Each week, I'll do 1 minute at the very end going for this one. This would be insane if I get this one. This is supposedly between 1 in 500 to 1 in 1,000 chances. Hopefully I didn't sound too nasally today. It's a little bit of allergies. Hopefully that doesn't blow it out too much. I'm definitely going to listen back to this week and see how the audio came through. Definitely want to be better at setting that every game or every stream instead of sort of playing it by ear and just like, oh, it probably, the way it was last time probably works the same this week, because I don't think that's the way it works. Yeah, that's cool. We got one more chance this week. Let's see if we get it. Again, shout out to everybody that followed. Shout out to everybody that came out and came to chat this week. I really appreciate you guys. I appreciate everyone that comes by, everyone that follows. It makes me happy. It's a great time talking to you guys. Thank you so much. That is Kitty Claw Friday. We'll be back next week with a brand new set of time. Going for the second brown guy. And look at this. We're getting closer to the back. Look at those guys. Will we move on to the blue guy next week? We'll see if I can make it 3 weeks in a row. That's Kitty Claw Friday. Hey, we got one. And we'll be back next week at the same time to go again. Go follow me on Twitch and subscribe here on YouTube to add one more minute to next week's video. If you want to see more here on YouTube, make sure to like and subscribe on your way out. And don't forget to check out my next video. Now stay safe and stay lucky. This is PadreBolt22, and I'll see you next time.